When the markets opened today, the S&P Dow Jones Indices was due to include 1,099 A shares in its global benchmarks, with a 25% inclusion factor. The A shares of 147 large-cap stocks, 251 mid-caps, and 701 small-caps come mainly from five sectors, including banking, finance, food and beverages, medicine, and electronics. At a partial inclusion factor of 25%, China's A shares are projected to represent a weight of 6.2% in the S&P Emerging BMI.
So, I mean, China has been, the China A share market, clearly has been, dominated by local investors for a long time. As A shares are added to global benchmarks, there'll be more sort of global institutional presence and ownership in the market. On the flip side, from the global investor perspective, are eager to have China represented at a more sort of accurate weight of how large the market is.
Also on Monday, FTSE Russell was to raise the weighting of A shares in its global benchmarks from 5% to 15% and include 87 new A shares constituents. The move marks the second stage of incorporating Chinese shares into its indexes. FTSE Russell first added Chinese shares to its indexes in June, 1,097 Chinese stocks, or 20% of Chinese A shares, were bought into the indexes, and another 40% was expected to be added next March.
So literally over this first phase, and we're going to include just over 1,000 China A shares, and that's large, mid, small, and micro-cap companies.
A-share inclusion steps of the two major investment index compilers are expected to generate $5.1 billion worth of inflow into A-shares.
From a FTSE Russell perspective, giving access to investors for our indices into the mainland Chinese market is a key component. We're expecting sort of on the 23rd of September around about 4 billion inflows. There's around about 140 billion tracking in our emerging market indices.
So the inclusion will provide more access to the faster growing economy, but certainly it also provides an opportunity for investors to gain exposure to within China.
Analysts say that foreign capital might continue to flow into the A-share market as the widely tracked global indexes start incorporating more Chinese shares. Lily Liu, CGTN.